Hello everyone. So this is continuation of this scheduling of previous video. Here we'll see another different means than living first come first serve and shortest seek time first. We'll see next algorithm for disk scheduling. So next algorithm is scan. So in the scan method, disk arm moves towards one end. Like unlike first come first serve or shortest time, the disk arm moves in one particular direction, and in that direction whatever values in the queue comes in between, disk stops there, allocated, then move towards the same direction unless it reaches the end. Once end has reached, then it will come back to the next value, like start value. From there again it moves to that end. So this is how scan method work. So if you take scan method with an example, so we have disk head start at 53, disk head is at 53, and we have the same queue with what we have seen in the last video as an example. So disk head is at 53, so in the scan method disk head moves to one direction, to the start value. So from there, means in between, from 53 to 60, whatever heads present in the queue will be scheduled first. So 53 is the head start point. So in the queue less than 53, what is the number which is less than 53, or you can see to the value which is towards 0. In the queue we have 37 and 14 towards 0. So first value which reaches towards 0 from 53 is 37. So head movement from 53 to 37. So head movement is from 53 to 37. To number of heads moved are 16. So from 37 towards 0 we have 14 in between. So head moves from 37 to 14. Number of heads moved to reach 14 are 23. So since it is scan method, if there are no values from 14 to 0, then also the head moves from 14 to 0. So basically it moves from 53 to 0, in between whatever heads present, where whatever heads to be scheduled will be scheduled. Okay, so from 53 to 37, 37 to 14, from 14 it will move to 0. So 14 to 0 heads moved are 14. Then from 0 it will start move towards another direction. So from 0 it starts moving in this direction, and there comes 65 in the queue. Since we have 65 in the queue, the next head movement is from 0 to 65. 0 to 65 is the next head movement, and heads moved are 65. From 65 it moves to 67, which is the next element in this direction. So 65 to 67 is 2. Next one is 67 to 98. So 67 to 98, the head moves from 67 to 98 in this direction with the values 31, or number of heads moved are 31. From 98 to 122, from 122 to 124, from 124 to 183, then you have reached all the values in the queue. So if you add all the total number of heads moved while this scheduling, you will get total number of head movements happened for this queue of head, sorry, disk scheduling. This is how scan method work. Advantage of this scan method over shortest seek time first is, whether the distance is more or less, each queue element need not to wait more, unlike shortest seek time. But here in the seek method, unwanted movements are happening from a head movement to the ends. So from 14 it is unwanted to move to 0. So this is like unwanted movements are happening in scan method. So next method is C scan method. So So C-scan method is like it provides more uniform wait time than scan. Head moves from one end of the disk to another, serving the request as it goes. It is like a scan method, but when it reaches other end, however, it immediately returns to the beginning of the disk without serving any request to the return trip. See here, it is like scan method. Instead of moving towards this direction, towards zero direction, it moves in forward direction. In scan method, head moved in backward direction, but it moves in forward direction. Once it reaches the end, instead of allocating the values in between, it directly moves to zero, then starts allocating the value. So, thinking of condition that if you start moving towards this direction, values under forward direction will be waiting. If you are in 53, thinking of condition that disk has moved in forward direction to 53, before like coming to 53, it has already allocated some values in the queue which were in forward direction. Why to go back and waste the time? Make another disk scheduling wait. So go towards forward direction, allocate it, then go to zero, then start allocating in forward direction. So in the C-scan method, disk is at 53, go towards forward direction, next value in this forward direction is 65, head movement from 53 to 65 and total head moves are 12, from 65 to 67 in the queue. After 67 we have 98, from 98 to 122, 122 to 124, 124 to 183. After 183, there is no other values in this direction, but also the head moves from 183 to 199. This C-scan method also suffers from unwanted movements of disk. So from see here 183, after the disk is moved to 183, it will move to the last position. That is, disk moves from 183 to 199, 16 values. Then from 199, it directly goes to 0. So from 199, it come back to 0, then start allocating the disk in forward direction. So from 0, the next value to be allocated was 14 and 37 were left, which were behind 53. So allocate them. And if you have next queue, start allocating them in this order. Once you find all the head movements and number of heads moved to reach from one head to another head, add everything, then you can find total head movements. Okay, I guess you understood the topic of C-scan method. So next method, to overcome this scan and C-scan, we have look method. Look and C-look are same as scan and look, but instead of moving from the last bit to the, sorry, from the allocated bit to the last bit, instead, if there is no any heads in that direction, from there you can schedule towards another direction. This is how C-look work. See here, if you compare C-scan, from 183 it went to 199, this is unwanted movement. From 199 to 0, which is unwanted. But in C-look, if it is forward allocation like C-scan, the value, head moves from 53 to 65, 65 to 67, 98, 122, 124, 183. After 183, there is no next value in the queue. Instead of going to 199 like C-scan, directly go to opposite direction, and instead of going to 0, go to the value which is in the queue. So in the queue, towards opposite direction, you have 37 and 14. So 14 is the smallest value. From 183, instead of going to 0, reach to 14. So no need of going from 0 to 199 and here 14 to 0. There is no need of this movements from CLOOK. Okay, so from 183 you can directly go to the value 14, from 14 to 37. So head moves from 53 to 65, 65 to 67, means in one direction till 183. After 183, instead of going to 199, go to reverse direction, and in reverse direction no need to go to 0, it will reach to 14, which is the next value or least value towards reverse direction. Stop there. From 14 you can allocate a forward direction. This is how CLOOK work. And total head movements with the help of CLOOK is 322, but if you compare C-scan, total head movements was 382. So we had two head movements, like 16 and 199 were waste of movements. So this disadvantage of unnecessary head movements of C-scan has overcome in CLOOK. So we have less number of head movements, so that because we have cut shorted the head movements of unwanted movement from 183 to 199, and from 199 it has to go to 0, but now we are moving from 183 to 14. So I hope you understood the topic. Thank you.